Divide them up into three different, we kind of one at a time. I think there's one on page one, there's one on page two, I think, and one on page four in the red bold. So we could vote on those separately. I would appreciate that, whether I do that by offering an amendment or if the maker of the motion would withdraw and the one at a time.
You can just request.
Divide the question?
Divide the question.
Well, anyway.
It's divisible when it comes in.
I can do that.
Okay.
Because they'll all have passed first reading if you want, because I'll just bring back three pieces, each of which piece will have passed first reading, which we consider separately at second.
So we can pass first reading tonight without, I might decide to vote against second reading as we separated.
Correct.
That's fine with me, then we can go home earlier.
All right.
So we have a motion to, yes, that's right.
Well, I just think for members of the public, it might be helpful for someone, maybe them, to go over each of these changes just so we hear, or Attorney Sullivan. And I have at least just to clarify a question about one of them. I know we'll get more information at second, because so many people are here tonight. It would be good to just hear what each of these is.
If good city attorney, it would probably be best.
Right now, Your Honor?
If that's possible, just put your other way.
No, I can do another.
Yeah, you don't have to bear with people here.
Okay. Uber is requested, first off, this amendment is drafted entirely to meet a request from Uber. It took a letter from the company and converted it into the ordinance amendment. And to be sure that I had done it in a way that satisfied Uber, I actually forwarded it to the company before it was put into the council. So the ordinance that you see in front of you has been approved by Uber as satisfying their request. And their request, first off, adds to the definition of transportation services, meaning the thing that is actually going to be regulated by this ordinance, adds this provision. Transportation services means the provision of transportation by a driver to a rider, beginning when the driver accepts a ride requested by a rider, continuing while the driver transports a requesting rider, and ending when the last requesting rider departs from the vehicle. That provision, as far as I can tell, has no bearing whatsoever on the city's regulation of the operation. I believe that it relates to Uber liability. I believe it's intended to create a situation where Uber only has liability during the period of time when the passenger is actually in the vehicle, so that call comes in, electronic communication goes to an Uber driver to go to a particular place. On the way to that place, the driver runs somebody over. Uber is not responsible with this kind of definition, I believe, under our ordinance. And that's what I believe is the logic behind that request. Number two, the current city ordinance on background check, transportation services carries with it the identical requirements that existed in the prior taxi ordinance. And Uber wishes to delete from that a provision that says that a person who has been convicted of a misdemeanor as opposed to a felony in the past 7 years would be ineligible to drive. In other words, that person would not be eligible now. Uber wants person to be eligible. And secondly, Uber wants to delete entirely the prohibition that we have now, which would prevent a person from being a driver if the individual has been convicted of a felony involving a controlled substance or violence in this or any other state in the 15 full years prior to the date of certification. Uber wants to have that restriction eliminated. And then the third change is that right now, the transportation services ordinance requires that inside every vehicle be a notice or a sign identifying to passengers that A, there is no fare regulation in the city and the person is to negotiate their fare with the operator of the vehicle, and number two, that there's an appeal provision to the Transportation Services Committee for any committee, or any individual who's unhappy with the way the fair negotiations have worked out, or has a problem with how the service was provided. Uber wishes to keep the portion of that notice which says fares aren't even negotiated, but Uber wishes to delete from our ordinance the requirement that the part about the appeal to the Transportation Services Commission be, or committee, be also on the notice. And those are the three changes.
Thank you very much. Council Kennedy.
First, I have a question for the city attorney. Have you ever sent an ordinance to a non-taxpaying entity in our city before?
You know, I might have. Nothing springs right to mind. But the uniqueness of this particular ordinance amendment was, it was in response to a request from Uber. So I wanted to make sure that I had written the thing that Uber was requesting to be brought before the council.
And follow up to that, I guess I am having a hard time. We've had the police tell us that they're not comfortable with the background check that Uber provides. You know, we are not, I have no problem saying if you have a felony for substance abuse or violence, that you can't drive someone for a period of time. I have no problem with that. And I think that should be, that's the safety of our citizens. We're dealing with our citizens. I mean, the interesting thing tonight is that there was no citizens here to speak to. There was people from outside of our community, which I respect, and I understand you're wanting to have business here. But my concern is that we have been over backwards for transportation services and an ordinance to support the new generation of transportation. And I'm not going to give away the safety of our community. And we have a police saying, telling us that their request for a background check is not substantial. And I know as an educator, we get background check a lot. And I'm sure you want me to have a substantial background check if I'm going to work with your children. And I'm still, this is sure, you're going to want a substantial background check if you get in a cab or an Uber or whatever, some kind of transportation with someone else. So I guess I'm not going to go forward with this. I thought we had a great compromise. We worked with Uber before. We listened to Uber, and we made substantial changes to our ordinance. But I'm not going to give up that background check to the level that our police department feels we should have in this community. If we vote for this, we're voting against our police department tonight, I believe.
Council Islam, Dwyer, endorsed.
Yeah, I think the council should at least pass this on to first reading. We can continue to debate these things and find out more about it, which is all what the process is intended to do. One of the questions, Mr. Harrison DeBree in the front row here indicated that he thought that the Uber background check was more thorough than the police check. I did speak to the police chief and also to the attorney for Uber on this issue, but I would like to know whether that is a correct statement, that the background check Uber does checks for terrorism and more outside the state of New Hampshire, and that's just a point I'd like some clarification, either tonight or during the process during first reading.
Council Swyer, Thorson, Moore.
I realize this is just a first reading, and I understand what Councilor Lyle said. It's important to me whether our taxi commission has approved of these, because I believe their view was mixed on these. Is this being brought to us by the taxi commission? Have they approved of these changes?
Can I answer that? Yes, please. The city council at the meeting 2 weeks ago approved asking for first reading based on the letter of October 19th that Uber had sent to the taxi commission, the Transportation Services Commission, the City Council. The Taxi Commission met, the Transportation Services Commission met about 2 weeks ago and took recommended votes on each of these, but the City Council had not asked the Transportation Services Commission to approve anything. It asked for any input it wanted to offer. I think that at the public hearing, we would have minutes of that meeting.
Okay.
Councilor Thorson.
Just a one point of clarification, city attorney. I had understood that the issue of the felony was the length of time rather than eliminating it altogether. I'm a little bit confused, I guess, because I thought that the issue was 15 years versus 7 years. And if I remember correctly, Uber's background checks were checking for 7 years and we were checking for 15, so there was a discrepancy there. And we were trying to align them. But what is being proposed is the entire elimination. So I'm a little confused. Maybe I didn't understand where we were going on that issue.
What you have in front of you is what has been requested by Uber and confirmed by Uber prior to bringing the ordinance.
Does their background check, obviously must check criminal background, and have they given you guidelines as to what those checks are, such that we can be assured that at just some level these things are being checked?
Well, I'll make 2 points on that. Number one, we actually have no idea what Uber's background check checked, because it's Uber's, not ours. We don't regulate it. Secondly, even though we're responding to a request from Uber here, the same deletion from the ordinance would apply to any transportation service provider, including someone who did no background checks at all.
Okay, that's an interesting point. I happen to agree with Councilor Lowndes' point about making a comparison between what we were proposing and what Uber is currently doing. But if we don't know what Uber is currently doing, how do we get to that point? And I guess maybe before second reading, we should maybe explore how to get that information.
Councilor Morgan.
Your Honor, I really would like to know, I was expecting to have some concrete feedback from transportation, the Shared Transportation Committee, which it seems like we don't have. And I kind of agree with Councilor Kennedy on her comments. You know, I don't feel comfortable with the language. That's my comment, and that's how I'm going to leave it for now.
Thank you. Anyone else? I'll pass it. Sister May's point.
Yeah, I want to clarify that the Transportation Services Committee took a vote against most of these suggestions. I am not chair of the committee, so I didn't feel, especially at first reading, that it would be my role to report to the council on it. There was a newspaper story about the meeting, it's been online, and I would expect on second reading that would be part of the record of the committee. I did not, of the commission, I did not take a vote. I did not participate in the votes during that meeting because I wanted to see what the result would be for the council. Secondly, my intent on all of this is certainly not to cheerlead for Uber. As a corporation, I have a lot of questions about the company of Uber. But I do think that Uber serves a purpose. Ride sharers, and this is not about Uber, ride sharers serve a purpose. And Sidecar and Lyft and other ride sharers that might be encouraged to come to Portsmouth have similar models as Uber, and these changes for a transportation network company would probably need to be made. I thought that it was wise to make it clear, delineating the three changes that are needed one by one in our ordinance in order to allow Uber or ride shares to be able to operate in Portsmouth. We're coming up with a holiday season in the spring, when we're going to need more transportation services than we currently have. So I thought this was a wise thing to do so that we are not going out there and giving citations to people, but we're allowing the company of Uber to be able to conform with our ordinance. And I think the public hearing is the proper way or place to do that. I agree with Councilors Lowndes Morgan, that we need the information of the side-by-side, and I would expect that Uber is going to, I would hope that Uber is going to tell us exactly why they think these changes are necessary, and then we can make our judgment after listening to residents as well as others as to whether or not we should do that on the 21st.
I'd like to pass the gavel to the assistant.
Recognize the good mayor, Bob Lister.
So I will, I've been pretty consistent in my votes, although I've never, I don't remember the last time I didn't vote for first reading, because we do need more information, but I've been very clear since the very beginning. We have been round and round with rideshare and Uber. There is probably enough work in this city for Uber and rideshare to be here. But what I've said is before, and very similar to Councilor Kennedy, you have to be concerned about public safety and insurance and background checks. We have an ordinance. The ordinance seems to fit the bill. You have to work, fill, you have to be able to follow the rules. That's all that we're asking. Uber keeps coming back and saying change it for this, change it for that. I'm not willing to do that. We're ready to go. There's plenty of business. All Uber has to do is follow the ordinance. And my feeling is that if you're going to be here, we have an ordinance. We spent more than enough time talking about this over the last months, over the last year. And we're going to move forward or we're not going to move forward. So I'm not supporting this ordinance change at all. We have an ordinance. You want to be here? Follow the rules.
Turn the gavel to the good mayor. May I ask a question of the good superintendent?
Certainly.
Is it my understanding, just for clarification purposes so that everybody understands, that currently anybody who operates for Uber or any ride sharing company in the city could go to the city clerk's office, pay $25 to file, it's about a 3-minute form, then go to the city, to your office, and verify that they have insurance liability coverage to protect riders to the degree that is required by the ordinance, go to the police department and either have a background check approved by them that they have, or to pay $25 in the background check, and they can be in business the next day.
Yeah, that's correct.
A call and question, Uber operators do we have, by the way?
There's definitely one Uber driver operating in that manner, and there's another one who may or may not have completed the process late this afternoon.
A technical question. Just on the third signage. The way I read it, a notice providing passengers with the fare information required by Section 7.209 of this ordinance. Section 7.209 includes, to me, both the fact that there's no regulation of fares, but it also indicates how disputes would be resolved. So, to me, that seems reasonable to me, but that does not seem to be what Uber was asking for. And I just want to know why you think that this language actually responds to removing how to resolve a dispute when it's part of 7.209.
It would be speculation on my part, but the speculation is that Uber didn't want to invite challenges to the Transportation Services Committee.
But I mean, it seems to me that this in fact says the same thing that we said already, that this is not a change. It's okay with me, but
the difference is that right now the notice would carry the full text of 209. But with the change, the notice would only carry the fare information in 209.
Okay, and I guess I was interpreting fare information broadly, and you're interpreting it only carries the first paragraph. All right, I get it.
Okay, so we call the court here on a point of clarification.
Yes.
The assistant mayor mentioned to resolve this prior to the holiday season. However, there's only one more council meeting before that. The only way that that's going to happen is if we suspend the rules and go to third reading following second reading. So I just wanted to point that out, that is the case. Is that right?
That is right.
Okay, thank you.
Roll call vote, please.